Guruji.
Yes, sir.
Yogi, Virendra Yogi.
Yes, sir.
Why Buddha enlightened?
Dr. Satyanarayana, you see what happens. There are a lot of orthodox, conservative people who are dogmatic and who does not understand how the nature works and how the scientific activities are happening, the different phenomena. So they become confused and they start thinking that there is some supernatural forces which is governing and which is really controlling their fate and destiny. But Buddha was a very different, greatest scientist of all time, like Darwin or like Einstein, because he tried to understand the basic philosophy of the natural phenomena. So he was integral part of nature itself. And so he knows every secret of the nature. He connected his mind with the natural forces. So you can say other way, the natural forces, this is something like a room, and you want to enter in that. Ordinary people cannot enter into that. But he was so much desirous, he was so much of curious, he was so much of intense, he was so much of aggressive, that he penetrated all the illusion. He broke all the walls which was preventing him from entering into the kingdom of knowledge, the kingdom of the mysterious laws of the nature. So he forced himself and he entered into that natural field and he saw everything from his own eyes. So he said, natural laws are the truth. Natural laws are the truth. So he learned every natural law. And he said, I am truth. Natural laws are truth. Any laws of nature is truth. There is no illusion. There is no fear. There is no confusion. Ordinary people say Allah, God. Even Jesus was confused. He said God. But he never talked about all these illusion, because he has clarity. That's why he is called enlightened. He become integral part of nature. Other way you can say, he just broke the wall of nature and came out as a nature. You don't understand what I mean? He was part of the nature. He was knowing every secret of nature and he jumped out from that. And he talked about natural laws. What is the laws of cause and effect? Sowing and reaping. Law of compensation. Law of karma, what we say. There are different ways to interpret this. But Buddha saw everything from his own eyes. He saw everything clearly. Because he was a part of the nature, and to realize that, he meditated, and he penetrated the difficult wall like the rock. He broke this every barrier, and he knew every secret of nature. That is truth. So if you want to be happy in life, learn what is truth, and follow the path of truth. That's why he said, Sangham Samam Gacchami, Dhammam Samham Gacchami, Bodham Saram Gacchami. Means, here is the place where you will know the truth, what Buddha had discovered. Ordinary people do not know that. Jesus learned everything from Buddha, but he has his own illusion, so he didn't talk so much as truth. He told, I am son of God. And he talked something about God. So have faith in God and everything. So you understand what is that? Einstein said, Buddha was the greatest scientist of all time, like Darwin. He never talked anything baseless, illusion, which cannot be verified and proven. And the ultimate wisdom of Buddha was, we are what we think. All that we are arises with our thought. With our thought we make the world. So Dr. Satyanarayana, thank you very much. This is my discovery. He emerged from the nature. And he talked only truth. And truth will never change, because it is natural law. Natural law will not change. The law of gravitation, the laws of motion, everything remains truth. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Guruji.